Hello, I am Dr. KK Mishra from R Classes. I welcome you all to my YouTube channel R Classes. This video tutorial is on UGC NTA NET paper first. This is part 23 on research aptitude. Now come to the questions. Question number 1. Which of the following is the least helpful to locating and analyzing problems? A. Exploring the literature in an area of interest. B. Discussing with the research guide. C. Examining everyday experiences. D. Critical analysis of the existing theories and practices. The correct option is C. Examining everyday experiences. 2. Sarah is a qualitative researcher studying how children and parents interact in Head Start centers. As she examines her data, videotapes and transcripts, she jots down notes concerning the interactions, generating hypotheses, suggesting relationships. Among categories of information she is examining and so on. This process of jotting notes as she examines the data is called A. Memoing. B. Transcription. C. Face sheet coding. D. Drawing diagrams. The correct option is A. Memoing. 3. Qualitative data analysis is still a relatively new and rapidly developing branch of research methodology. A. True or B. False. C. Neither true nor false. D. None. The correct option is A. True. 4. The process of making segments of data with symbols, descriptive words or category names is known as A. Conquering. B. Coding. C. Coloring. D. Segmenting. The correct option is B. Coding. 5. What is the cyclical process of collecting and analyzing data during a single research study called? A. Interim analysis. B. Internal analysis. C. Inter-item analysis. Or D. Constant analysis. The correct option is A. Interim analysis. 6. Which of the following is / are necessary conditions for causation? A. The relationship condition. B. The temporal antecedents condition. C. The lack of alternative explanation condition. D. All. The correct option is D. All. 7. Which of the following is the weakest experimental design? A. One group pretest post-test design. B. Quasi-experimental design. C. Two group post-test only design. Or D. Ex post facto design. The correct option is B. Quasi-experimental design. 8. The development of a solid foundation of reliable knowledge typically is built from which type of research? The correct option is A. Basic research. 9. Which form of reasoning is the process of drawing a specific conclusion from a set of premises? A. Rationalism. B. Deductive reasoning. C. Inductive reasoning. D. Probabilistic. Correct option is B. Deductive reasoning. 10. Which of the following statement is correct? A. Research objectives can be worded in question form. B. Research objectives can be worded in statement form. C. Objectives are to be stated in chapter first of the thesis. D. All. The correct option is D. All. 11. The difference between experimental research and historical research is the process of A. The formulation of the hypothesis. B. The testing of hypothesis. C. Replication. Or D. All. The correct option is D. All. 12. The research is always A. Verifying the old knowledge. B. Exploring new knowledge. C. Filling the gap between knowledge. D. All. The correct option is D. All. 13. In every field, research pursuits promote systematic and gradual advancement of knowledge. But discoveries are rare because the correct option is A. research is a continuous critical investigation. 14. What makes people to undertake research? A. Desire to face the challenge in solving the unsolved problems. B. Desire to get a research degree along with its consequential benefits. C. Desire to get intellectual joy of doing some creative work. D. All. Here, correct option is D. All. 15. A satisfactory quantitative method should not possess one of the following qualities. A. Appropriateness. B. Measurability. C. Comparability. D. Flexibility. Here, correct option is D. Flexibility. 16. A big bank contains an equal number of 1 rupee 50 paise and 25 paise coins. Big bag. If the total amount is in the bag is 35, how many coins of each type are there? If you calculate it, you will find it to be C as correct one, 20. 17. A research problem is not feasible only when A. It is researchable. B. It is new and adds something to knowledge. C. It consists of independent and dependent variables. D. It has utility and relevance. The correct option is B. It is new and adds something to knowledge. 18. If the sample drawn does not specify any condition about the parameter of the population, it is called A. Selected statistics. B. Distribution-free statistics. C. Census. D. None. The correct option is A. Selected statistics. 19. Which opinion is not correct? So here correct option is C. Patent, inventions, design, copyright and trademarks are the subject of concurrent list. 20. A dogma is different from a theory in respect of any one of the following. A. Experimental verification. B. Conviction. C. Assumption. D. Acceptability. The correct option is A. Experimental verification. 21. All are the examples of qualitative variables except A. Religion and caste. B. Sex. C. Observation. D. Interest of the subject. Correct option is D. Interest of the subject. 22. Which of the following is not a step of research? A. Selecting a topic. B. Framing research questions. C. Surveying the research topic. D. None. The correct option is D. None. 23. What is the full form of abbreviation HFT used in research? A. Holzman ink block test. B. Hofkins Ajax test. C. Higher intelligence test. D. Hinz informative test. The correct option is A. Holzman ink block test. 24. In order to produce a quality of research, it depends on A. Use of high technology. B. Available facilities. C. Training in research methodology. Or D. Deduction on the part of researcher. Correct option is C. Dedication on the part of researcher. 25. Which of the following sampling method is appropriate to study the prevalence of AIDS among male and female in India in 76, 86, 96 or 2006? The correct option is D. Stratified random sampling. 26. Which of the following are the examples of qualitative variable? A. Religion and caste. B. Sex. C. Both. A and B. D. None. The correct option is C. Both A and B. 27. Which of the following are components of ethical research? A. Disclosure. B. Understanding. C. Competence. D. All. The correct option is D. All. 28. Probability sampling implies A. Stratified random sampling. B. Systematic random sampling. C. Simple random sampling. D. All. The correct option is D. All. 29. The research guide requires which of the following essential qualities? A. Subject matter expertise. B. Methodological expertise. C. Interdisciplinary expertise. D. All. The correct option is D. All. 30. Which technique is generally followed when the population is finite? A. Area sampling technique. B. Purposive sampling technique. C. Systematic sampling technique. Or D. None. The correct option is C. Systematic sampling technique. So this was all about this particular video tutorial. I hope that you have liked it, and if you have liked it, please do not forget to subscribe my YouTube channel R Classes and press the bell button and pass on to others, those who are needy now and in the future. Thank you. Please like, share and subscribe. Thank you very much. Have a nice time. Best of luck.